Now we're going to do the summary of the antifungal medications that we have. We have the echinocandins, azoles, terbinafine, griseofulvine, polyens that include nystatin and amphotericin B. Hotezazole, terbinafine, griseofulvine, and fluocytosine. Alright, so we have this cell, the fungi cell. In the nucleus, here, the inhibition of the chain replication of the RNA, for example, the synthesis of RNA is inhibited by the fluocytosine goes here and inhibit the RNA polymerase. Well, those chain termination, because the RNA polymerase inserts the fluocytosine that is converted into 5-fluoracil because of the cytosine deaminase enzyme, then is 3-phosphorylated, and so is similar to the uridine 3-phosphate, and so it is incorporated into the growing chain, and so is the chain termination. Alright. Next, here in the nucleus also is griseofulvine. Griseofulvine could be, well, not exactly in the nucleus, but in the replication of the cell in which the chromosomes are aligned and the microtubules are pulling them on each cell. That is, griseofulvine inhibits that because it inhibits the polymerization of the microtubules. And if we do not have polymerization, then we cannot pull the chromosomes to each cell. Alright, so griseofulvine inhibits the polymerization of the microtubules, is carcinogen, teratogenic, and interacts with the cytochrome P450 enzymes. So the metabolism of many drugs that are metabolized by those enzymes is increased, and so we need to increase the dosage of that drugs. Or instead of giving griseofulvine, we give other things, because griseofulvine is potentiating the action, or we say activator of those enzymes, and so the medication effect of the other drugs is less in duration. Alright, and there is only oral medication for this. The polyens act in the membrane, in the cell wall membrane, in the cellular membrane of the fungi, because binds to ergosterol. If they bind to ergosterol, they form a pore through which the electrolytes leak. So we have leakage of electrolytes, and diseases in which we're going to give polyens are very different diseases, very invasive diseases. Like for amphotericin B, would be invasive diseases in the morphic fungi. For nystatin, could be invasive or non-invasive, but nystatin is very, very toxic, so we do not give it intravenous. The nystatin only we give it in 3 occasions mostly. That is diaper rash, thrush, oral candidiasis, and vaginal candidiasis. Alright, amphotericin B can produce anemia, flushing fever. It's better if you give it with potassium and magnesium administration, also natrium administration and sodium administration, and can produce renal tubular acidosis type 1 and anemia. Alright, next, the echinocandins binds to the, or inhibit the synthesis of the 1,2-D glucan. Inhibiting this is inhibiting the synthesis of the cellular wall of the fungi, because the glucan is a critical component of the cellular wall. Adverse effects is just flushing because of histamine release and GI tract upset. It's reserved for IV administration in the cocutaneous, anti-invasive aspergillosis, and candidiasis. Next, the Terbinafine, the same way as griseofulvine, are mainly used for dermatophyton infection. terbinafine sometimes is greater in onychomycosis infection than griseofulvin. Terbinafine binds to the esqualene epoxidase enzyme, the enzyme that converts esqualene into esqualene epoxide, and we're going to see this reaction shortly. Next, if we inhibit this, at the end we're inhibiting ergosterol synthesis, and so this cell wall and the cell membrane is not functioning. And terbinafine adverse effects are GI, headache, liver function test elevation or abnormalities because of potential hepatotoxicity, and some disturbance in the taste. Lastly, azole binds to the 14-alpha-dimethylase enzyme, the one that converts finally lanosterol to ergosterol. And so again, we're inhibiting ergosterol synthesis. We have a lot of azoles, ketoconazole, clotrimazole, miconazole, etc. We already have a video on this. So, we have, first, the reaction is, we have esqualene that is converted into esqualene epoxide by the esqualene epoxidase. Next, esqualene epoxide is converted to lanosterol, and lanosterol is converted to ergosterol. Inhibition of this enzyme is by terbinafine. Inhibition of lanosterol to ergosterol are the azoles.